Today I want to talk about my favorite color, gold, and why is it my favorite color? Somebody just asked me, and I've been thinking, earlier it has been blue, then I started loving all colors, you see, very colorful, but gold is still very meaningful to me. The reason is that I didn't grow up with money. I had no idea about money, and I had a time where I was sleeping on the floor with no money, couldn't pay my bills, and this in Switzerland, one of the richest countries, but I still couldn't make any money at this low point of my life. And that's when I started, after that, that's when I started, you know, rediscovering myself, just like throwing everything old out of the way, and then I found painting. And painting gave me so much love, so much joy, so much abundance. But at first it wasn't like this. So let me tell you the story. When I was around 20 years old, I was a photographer. I thought, this is my mission, this is what I love. And I also did, because I was working in Burger King before that. I was working in part-time jobs that I didn't like. I always felt like I didn't have any talents. I felt judged, I was tired all the time, I had no energy. And I was always wondering why, I was wondering what's wrong with me. But on one point I realized nothing is wrong with me. But it took some time to realize that. It really took time, and it took time to look deep into my soul and to discover more, to take risks. So what I've been doing is I went to India with my brother, and I had really time to think. And I knew when the last few days before we went back to Switzerland, I made myself a promise that I won't work in a job again, that I want to find something I love and make money with that. So my family, I mean, I never grew up with money. I don't want to say my family never had money. We are living in Switzerland, but my mom, for example, she never worked. She didn't work for 30, 40 years. She got money from the social amt. So she actually never, she got the pure minimum that's possible to live with in Switzerland. It's still a good life in comparison to other countries, so I don't want to complain. But I grew up with this mindset, and this led me to the point where I then like struggled a lot. So when I decided to go back to Switzerland and find something I love, I had a camera in my hands in India. I made great photos for my brother, from the nature, the landscapes. So it was like, obviously I need to try that. Maybe it's photography, that's something I enjoy more than, you know, staying in front in Burger King saying all the time the same thing. When I came back, I said, like, this is it. Now I learn about photography, now I become a really good photographer and make money with it, so I can live the life I really love to live. And I don't feel this tightness anymore when I have holidays and go back. I didn't want to live this life. And what happened then is then I quit in Burger King, and I thought I can make it immediately. I thought I go now to change the place, so I moved to another place in Switzerland, went to close to my brother. And that's when it hit me. I tried to make money, I tried to approach people, I was too shy, I couldn't make it, I didn't have the mindset yet, because I grew up with this mindset of lack of scarcity. So this is what I went into my new place, the new place. I went with the same mindset, so I took myself with me. I thought that changing the place will change everything, but it didn't, because I took my mindset with me. So to make the story not too long, what happened is that I didn't make money for like 4 months. I needed to change apartments. I didn't have money to pay rent. The universe supported me. The universe gave me an opportunity that I could sleep in an empty apartment, because I met a real estate agent. And that was at the shooting. So, okay, this I need to tell quickly, because it's super crazy inspiring. I was at the shooting. That was the day I needed to move out of the apartment I was in. And I didn't have anything. I didn't have a job. I didn't have money. I didn't have an apartment. So where should I go? And I went to the shooting, and that's where the model invited another photographer. And in the end, when I wanted to go from the photo shooting, because I got nervous and I'm like, I don't have anything, what should I do? So I told them I need to go. They were asking why, we are not done. And then I told them the whole story. I was honest, I was vulnerable. And that's when the guy said, wait a minute, I'm a real estate agent. I own houses and apartments. I can get you an apartment for free right now, because I know you're in deep shit. That's basically, that was it. So he made a few phone calls. 50 minutes later, he had an apartment for me. The apartment was very empty. I didn't have many belongings. It was quite a It was not a nice area from Basel. Maybe you, if you're in Switzerland, you know Basel. It was not a nice area, but I had something. I was so grateful, and there was the universe supporting me. And I was vulnerable, I was honest, I was transparent, and that's when the universe could support me. So if you need help, ask for it. That's number one. That's what I want to give you the point here on this story. And then it went further. I slept on the floor. I didn't have a mattress. I didn't have a sheet to cover myself up, so I slept with the towels on the floor, didn't have money for food, so I lived like this, in this state of lack and scarcity for like 2-3 months, and that's when I decided I need to change something. Gratitude brought me out of it. Gratitude changed everything for me. So I became grateful for what I have, and that's when everything changed, and that's when I slowly built myself up. Why I'm telling you this? Because I want to say that I didn't come from abundance. I might now live in a state of more abundance. With my golden paintings, I live in a beautiful apartment with amazing art. I have a beautiful relationship. I do what I love and I make money with it. But it wasn't like this all the time. So that's why gold means so much to me. I really hope that this story inspires you to believe in yourself, and no matter what, just to keep going, because that's what I did. I kept going. I needed to build myself up. And through this experience, through this low experience of my life, when I went back actually to my mom, because I had nothing, no money, no job, nothing. But gratitude made me humble again. And I went back to my mom, and that's when I built myself up step by step. That's when I started reading books about creativity, about how to heal blockages. And then I healed my blockages and limitations, and I started painting. And that's when everything changed. It took a while, it took time. You know, change sometimes takes time, and you need to take the time. Don't rush it. So when I, like, fast forward 4 or 5 years later, I was committed on my self-growth. I was committed to stay, you know, on this journey to improve myself, to heal myself. And what happened then is amazing. I was in a job that was great. It was really great. I found something that I loved to a certain degree and where I could learn a lot. That's another thing. Work to learn, not to earn. And that's what I did. I worked with mentors and helped them wherever I could so I can learn as much as possible so I can create my own business and later on can do what I love, which took me like 3 years. And after that, I was ready. I quit my job. I made more money than ever with my art, with doing what I love. And I finally felt abundance, specifically in a financial perspective. I know abundance is in everything. Abundance is in relationships, in how you feel. And this is very much connected. Abundance is so much connected to you, how you feel. If you feel abundant, you will attract abundance. And that's what happened to me in 2020, in July. That's actually when I quit my job. It happened already in April, May. That's when I started attracting abundance like crazy, and that's when I created my abundance series, because I wanted to share this abundance with you and bring to you this feeling of abundance in a form of an artwork, so you can feel what I felt and what I still feel. So this is the short story, the 8-minute story about why I love gold and why it's my favorite color. I really hope this story inspires you. No matter where you're at in your life right now, just go, just keep going, believe in yourself, be humble, be grateful for what you have, and this will take you out of whatever mind space you are right now, whatever situation you are. If you come back to gratitude and you really, really feel it, it will bring you out of every misery. And then slowly you can start into going into a mindset and in a feeling, like start to feel abundance step by step. And when you start really to feel gratitude and abundance and appreciation, that's when you start to attract much more and can live a life of pure possibilities, abundance, and love. Thank you guys for watching. I wish you all the best and see you soon.